Welcome to Critical Encounters Gameplay Stream. I am your villainous host, Steve. And here we go. X-Men to me, my X-Men number four. That's my dog. Number four. My dog does not like tonight's game because we're going to be playing Kitty Pride. Ha ha. Boom, ching. Yeah, dad joke. Sorry, guys. So this is my four X-Men pre-con series up against previous scenarios. And this one is the Marvel Champions Monthly Challenge. They had, when they started their part one of their three-part series looking at the Mutant Genesis box. So Sko, who they had on as a guest, put this challenge out there. So we are looking at Crossbones. I'm going to play on Standard because it is a pre-con. So we have Crossbones deck. He said we're going to play with Weapon Master. Okay, I've got Standard in my obligation. I also said that we're going to use the Symbiotic Strength from Venom. So we've got some Enraged Symbiotes, some Webbed Ups, and other stuff like that. And then the third one is our choice. So I'm going back to Zero Tolerance. I want to play with one of the modulars out of the Mutant Justice box. So that gives us a additional loss condition. All right, and this is my weapons deck, so I'm going to shuffle that. It's parts required. Okay, I'm going to set that off to the side. Okay, so we're going to take all this and shuffle. So Crossbones is only a 1-1 with 12 health Hydra Mercenary, but while he has a weapon attachment, his attacks gain piercing, which I don't care about the piercing part, but multiple attacks could be tricky. There's a lot of cards in here that are going to trigger an extra attack, which means Kitty's defense will be a little trickier. All right, so attack on Mount Athena. It says create the experimental weapons deck. Put it over here. So we've done that. All right, starts at zero, goes up by one, and when revealed, reveal the top card of the experimental weapons deck. Crossbones has his energy shield, so he has retaliate one. And you can spend an energy and a mental to get rid of the energy shield. But also gives him piercing. So, by the virtue of it being a weapon. Although it is a shield. Okay. I'm sure we talked about that way back when we did experimental weapons. Okay. Alright, so let's keep shuffling here. Shuffle that up. Alright. You've seen my shuffling before. You know, could use some help. Alright, Kitty Pride. So if you haven't seen her, there are a lot of great videos out there too. But a quick rundown. She starts with a mass form upgrade. She can flip it once per round. On her hero side, nice triple twos. X-Men. And while you're in phased form, that's this side, can ignore guard and patrol keywords, and any crisis icons. Okay, 5 cards and 9 health. That's great, okay, good. But here's the fun piece, solid. It's permanent, so it can only leave play from its own effects. And it is the mass form, hero resource. Exhaust it, generate a physical resource for an attack or defense event. And as a response, you can choose, this is enforced, after you attack or defend in solid mass form, flip it. So you become phased. This is mass form, permanent. While Shadowcat is defending, she cannot take damage while she's defending. All right? So better than Vision's intangible form, which just, he can't defend and he takes 2 less. This one is, if you're defending, no damage. But you do have to defend. So you got a basic defend, or you got to use a defense action off a card. But force response after you attack or defend in phased form, flip it back. So you can't control it. Once you've taken an action in phased, that's an attack or a defense, you have to flip back. But there's no limit on the number of times you can flip. Okay? There's a limit on the number of times you're going to use the resource because it's going to exhaust. All right, like I said, this is just the pre-con out of the box. So it's aggression. We'll see how it goes. She's got a fun nemesis, the White Queen, psionic character in the Hellfire Club stuff with some pawns. So we'll see if she comes into play or not. Okay. Here we go. I'm going to start with 6 hand size. All right. Phased strike, which is 6 damage to an enemy, and if you're in phased form, you can discard an attachment. Oh, there we go. All right. Team strike. Let's see what energy mansion, phased and confused, which is great. Oh man, all these cards are good. All right. This is an attack. All right. Well, I think I'm just going to 2-3 for one of these. 1-2-3 for this thing. Yeah, I'm just going to keep my hand, all right? So I'm going to flip. All right, so what I want to do is I want to try to use this in phase form. So what I am going to start with is a attack from Shadowcat, all right? Sure, it's a retaliate one. I'm going to take that one time, okay? I have attacked. Oh, man, but I want to use that for this to be in phased. Ooh. Maybe it's not doable. What I was hoping for, that'll flip me, but I won't be flipped in time. So it's this little puzzle, right? I'd love to be in phased to get the kicker to pull that off. But it can't be in phase unless I attack, and if I do that, then I don't have the resource to spend to be in phase, right? But I'll come back. Yeah, but I won't have, I mean, I can just do it again instead of this, but I really want this. Wow, that's tricky, huh? Tricky, tricky. So let's start the beginning of the round and really look at this. All right, this is where I'm at the start. So I can use that, those two and that, to do this. And then I have these three for that. And I just won't be able to strip off the energy shield. Which I guess is fine, because this face and confuse is great. It's either that or like two phase strikes and just flip them on turn one. I'm not ready for that. Okay. So less than ideal, but pretty darn good. Solid and in strength for a phase strike. I'm just going to hit him for 6. Okay, that is an attack. That doesn't mean I take a retaliate. All right, then I'm going to flip it because I did an attack. So now I'm in phased. Oh, do I want to do that? This doesn't matter. I'm going to spend these 3 to phase and confuse him. So hero form only attached to an enemy, max 1 per enemy. When the attached enemy would attack, discard this card, then confuse him. So he's not going to attack, and then he will be confused. If I attack, I'll flip it back. He won't be able to attack. Could get something else. That's fine. I'm going to attack for 2. Alright, keep putting the pressure on. 1 retaliate. Alright, and since I attack, I flip back to solid. I ready up, I draw 5. Okay. Some toe to toes, some ready to rumbles, which lets me ready up. Training gatekeeper, airwalk, which lets me pull some threat. Okay. Alright, 1 threat per player. Crossbones doesn't attack because he is phased and confused. Well, he's phased. Now he's confused. Because that's what this does. Make sure I have my discard pile right. Alright. 1 encounter card. Enraged Symbiote. Garden Patrol. Which I can ignore when I'm phased. He's only a 2. Okay, my turn. Alright, I am going to attack in solid form. See, I don't get that resource. That's fine. This enraged symbiote for 2. Killing it. Okay. I'll flip to phased. Energy. Of course, it's the ready to rumble. Mental. But I'm going to do it. Energy and a mental to pull off this energy shield. Okay. Then I will spend one for a toe-to-toe. Choose an enemy. This guy. He's going to attack me. And then I'm going to deal him 5. All right. So he's going to attack me. Attack for 1 and a boost, but I'm phased. Oh, but I can't defend. See? Well. Oh, whatever. 2 damage. Okay. Then I deal him 5, which takes him out. Okay. So we're going to go to 2. So the second form is 2-2 with 14 health. While he has a weapon, his attacks are piercing. And when revealed, search and counter deck discard pile for his machine gun. Alright, so let's go see. Find his machine gun. Put both the assaults down here. There's his machine gun. We will shuffle. So his machine gun is going to attach to him. It's a weapon. 2 ammo counters per player. Okay. When Crossbones attacks you, it's an interrupt, so it happens as soon as he starts. It's not a response, that's after the attack is over with. When Crossbones attacks you, remove 1 ammo counter from this card. Discard the top card of the encounter deck and take indirect damage equal to the number of boost icons. So it can swing from like a 0 to a 1. So it can swing from a 0 to a 3. And it's always a 3 at the worst time, and a 1, you know, when you have like a tough, you're like, oh, I'll take out my tough, and then it's only a 1. Which always kind of feels bad. Okay. I put the boost card in my deck, or my discard pile. All right, since he is confused still, I'm gonna flip over into Kitty Pride. I'll just leave it phased. I have an airwalk to pull some threat off next turn, I think. I'll hold on to this. I get readied and I get 5 more. Oh, shoot. Two, 4, 6. All right, Shadowcat Surprise. So that's an attack with a ready. That's nice. Acute Control and Interference lets me have some fun if I have minions or crisis side schemes out. Airwalk lets me move threat, and Aggressive Energy is for attack events. So it'll let me pump up the damage. All right, that's cool. All right, 1 threat on the main scheme. Crossbones is confused. I'm going to get an encounter card. Hydra Sidearm, attached to the villain. When attached villain attacks, the attack gains range, so now he's ranged and piercing. I don't have any retaliate, I don't think, so it's not a big deal, but it is a +1. He can spend some resources to pull it off. Alright, my turn. Alright, I am going to recover. Okay. Phased. Use your ability to go into solid form. Then I'm going to flip. Then I'm going to use the solid form and aggressive energy for a Shadowcat Surprise to deal 3 damage to an enemy. Alright, when you spend this card for an attack event, this was used for an attack event as well, that event deals 1 additional damage. So 3, 4 damage. Down to 10. Okay. And then there's Ready My Hero. And I get to flip to phased because of that. Okay. I'll airwalk. Which one of these? I'll spend an airwalk on an airwalk. Move forth two threat. Okay. Cute control. Oh, maybe I don't do that. No, hold on. Because I am phased. I'll just straight up thwart for two. Okay. These are all mental resources, so I can't pull. So I'm actually going to spend both airwalks to play acute control and intangible interference. So if I ignore guard or patrol, I can exhaust it to do two damage to the minion that I'm ignoring. On a minion, what happens if I have three guard minions out? Can I use it if I have more than one guard minion? Intangible interference. Yeah, that's after I ignore a crisis icon on a scheme, you add two threat to the scheme. So little by little, you can kill off the guards in the crisis. Okay, ready? And draw. Kitty's Room, Colossus, Shadow, and Steel. Hey, two of them at the same time. Not that I have the money. Ooh, Phase and Confuse and a Shadowcat Surprise. All right, so I'm looking for five resources. One, two, three, four. So I don't have enough to do them both. We'll have to see how it goes. Okay. One threat. These aren't defense cards, are there? Oh, Shadow and Steel is a defense. When an enemy attacks, prevent all damage from that attack and deal four damage to the attacking enemy. But I don't have Colossus out. Okay. Alright, he's going to attack, which means I'm going to flip one of these, and I'm going to take damage equal to the boost, which is a 2. Indirect. I don't have any minions. I'm sorry. Allies. Okay. Then he's going to attack for 2. I don't have a defense card, so I'm going to exhaust to defend. Give the villain a tough status if you cannot heal 3 damage. Okay. It's tough. So he hits for 2. 3. I don't take any damage. I defended. Alright. Boost encounter card. Sentinel Mark. 2. When revealed. If Operation Zero Tolerance is in play, this card gains surge. Otherwise, search for Operation Zero Tolerance side scheme and reveal it. Alright. The Sentinels heard that I was fighting Crossbones, and they've decided to show up. Operation Zero Tolerance starts with 3. After an enemy attacks and defeats an ally, you put it under here. And in this case, if there are 4 allies under there, I lose. Alright, I'm going to move the weapon deck there, and I'm going to put this up here. Okay. Alright, I did defend, so I had to flip to solid form. It's just a lot going on. Pay attention, right? Pay attention. So, again, I don't have... Oh, I do have the right, but I have to use Phase and Confuse for that, which is not worth it. The question is... Well, he's got this, too. Oh. I'm going to try to deal with the board a little bit. I'm going to burn 3 cards for Phase and Confuse. Leaves me with a Shadowcat Surprise, which I don't have enough resources for. I'll end my turn and ready. I'm going to keep this. 2. There it is. 3. 4. 5. Okay. 1 threat on the main scheme. He doesn't attack because of the Phase and Confuse, which means this doesn't go off. This is when he attacks you, and this is when attached enemy would attack. So this pops first. He does not attack, and he becomes confused. Okay. The Sentinel Mark 2 is going to attack me, and I'm going to take 2 damage from it. I'm going to get a boost. I'm going to get an encounter card. Violent tendencies attached to the villain. It is a condition. After attached villain takes any amount of damage from an attack, give attached villain 1 face down boost card. If that attack dealt 3 or more damage to the attached villain, we get rid of this. So you want to hit him for 3. Okay. Boy. Okay. Alright. I'm going to try to... I'm going to attack for 2 into this thing. Which, oh, use... That'll flip me to phased. Alright, I'm going to spend its energy to play Lockheed. After Lockheed enters play, if I am phased, remove 2 threat from a scheme. I'm going to take 2 off of the main. Lockheed will then attack and remove the tough. Takes any amount of damage, so he didn't take any damage because there was a tough there. And then I will spend 2 more for Shadowcat Surprise to deal 3 damage to an enemy and ready my hero. So I'm going to ready. That'll flip me back forcibly. I'll deal 3 damage to him. That will... He gets a bonus boost card. But I dealt 3, so this gets discarded. A lot going on. Alright. And then Shadowcat is ready. She could punch for 2 more, putting him into 5. There's no retaliates out, so let's hit for 2 more. Okay. Then I'm going to flip. I could go phased. Sure, I'll flip the phase. I don't even know if I want to. Then I'll end my turn. Just in case. Alright, and then I'll ready. Ready, in case there's that symbiotic strength card that, like, flip to hero form and you get attacked. So I'm ready. Okay. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... 6. Team Strike. You can only play it if you're an X-Men, and then exhaust your hero on any number of X-Men allies. Deal damage among enemies where X is the total. Okay. Toe-to-toe. There we go. That can finish it. Quick Shift's not going to help. Genius. Quick Shift. Shadowcat Surprise. Alright. I've got Death, I think, on board in my hand. So can I survive? 1 threat. Confused, so this isn't going to trigger. This doesn't trigger. This isn't a trigger. This isn't a trigger. And then he's going to attack. I'm sorry. He's got an encounter card. Caught off guard. I'll get rid of this crisis one. And keep the guard one just in case somehow something magical happens. Okay. All right. Okay, I'm not even going to bother here. I'm going to flip. I'm going to spend a team strike for toe-to-toe. Oh, well, if you... this will trigger, huh? Can I do it the other way? Yeah. All right. I'll attack for 2. When I attack, I flip back. I don't have a physical I want to spend on that. So I'm going to end up using this for physical. And team... I don't know. No, who cares? Yeah. Let's not get funny. Team Strike. That's two for Shadowcat Surprise. I deal 3 damage to an enemy. Ready. Hey! Oh! Alright. Yeah, I was thinking I could use the toe-to-toe. What? If I had used the toe-to-toe, first card would have been Machine Gun for one. Okay, it had been down to three. He attacks and I would have been phased, right? I defend. And he would have hit for 2 damage. So, yep. Not a big deal. Okay. And what was the boost? Oh, he would have had that one too. Another one. Well, I didn't even need the... Could use the quick shifts too. Right? With the toe-to-toe. Anyhow, there you go. This is Shadowcat. It's pre-con. Versus the MCM Challenge. Wow, I feel bad for these villains. Against Shadowcat, she's just really good. Even on the pre-con. Although, I did not really get to use her phase to prevent a lot of damage because the pre-con didn't have a lot of defense actions that I could use. So I had to defend. Looking good. That's the end of the series, folks. That's 2 wins for the X-Men, 2 losses for the X-Men, or shall we say 2 wins for the villains? We'll see what I come up with next. Do you have suggestions? What do you want to see us playing? Hey, let us know that you want to see Mike play on stream. We want some of his fun games back, don't we? Yeah, let him know. And we'll see you on the show. So thanks for watching. Bye-bye.